In this video, I'm going to show you how to install your axles on your transaxle with the use of axle reinforcement plates. Okay, so these are not a stock Volkswagen part. You're not going to find them in any manual. MP sells them, or for a few dollars more, you can get them from Jeanberg Enterprises. And they're originally manufactured and sold for off-road bugs or for drag racing. And the purpose was to prevent leaks in the axle flanges, either from jumping the car or from hard starts. So that's the original purpose, but I'm adapting them to a regular street vehicle. On a street car, the axle flanges here are the weak link in this setup. This metal here is pretty thin and it's somewhat flexible. And after 50 plus years, there's a good chance it's not completely true, not completely straight, either from wear and tear or from somebody over torquing the nuts that go through these holes that are used to clamp this down. So using the axle reinforcement plates is a way to keep this as flat as possible and prevent leaks. So you can paint these like I did to prevent them from rusting. They came just as like bare metal coated in oil. You can either paint them or not paint them. The metal is really thick, so chances are they'll outlast the rest of the car. The car will rust away before these things do, and they'll probably outlast you too. The first step is to swap out the stock length studs for the longer ones that come in the kit. So before you install your axle and your axle tube, you need to know how many gaskets to put on the end. The question is, how do you figure that out? How is that determined? So the answer is trial and error. You're gonna have to bolt and unbolt your axle on probably more than once. Start out with two gaskets, and if it's too tight, you add a gasket. If it's too loose, you remove a gasket, but you have to bolt the axle on and off a few times in order to get it right. And how do you know if it's right? Pretty simple. This is the right side already installed. So like when the axle is set up properly, it's gonna fall under its own weight. There's gonna be no in and out play, and there's a slight drag on the axle that you can feel when you raise and lower it. So that's pretty much how you determine if the axle is set up properly, but it's solely through trial and error. So this is the original left axle that came out of the car along with the original side gear and fulcrum plates. And if you're reusing your parts, I recommend keeping left and right separated. Don't swap sides and don't mix up your parts, because if you do, you can have a problem. The parts are worn in together and it's best to keep them together. Otherwise they could break or have a problem or just not wear evenly. This is an aftermarket side gear I bought off the internet to replace my right gear, which was bad. And turns out that this is also bad. It won't fit into the transaxle at all. It's completely useless. This might work with a Brazilian or Mexican transaxle, but it won't work on a German transaxle. So don't even bother with it. If you have a problem with your side gears, see if you can find some good used original German side gears to replace them, but I would not mess with aftermarket stuff. These are aftermarket fulcrum plates, and as you can see, they come with a groove in them. These don't really fit very well unless you sand them down. You get a wet sand these so that you can fit the end of the axle spade in here with the fulcrum plates. Otherwise, you should probably just reuse your originals if they're in good condition. But if these are not in good condition and you need to buy new fulcrum plates, chances are they might not fit, so you need to wet sand. And the other thing I recommend is getting this brand CSP brand gaskets, because they give you a bunch of gaskets in the kit, and there's two thinner gaskets in here, as well as a bunch of thick gaskets, and that will allow you to fine tune this whole setup and get it perfect. Before you do anything, look inside the transaxle and you'll see a pair of spider gears. Make sure they're pushed apart. Just slide them to opposite ends or the teeth of the side gear won't fully engage.
Step one, take some gear oil and grease up my fulcrum plates and the side gear. Grease up the end of the axle spade. Fulcrum plates go into the side gear. Stick your finger in the back to hold the fulcrums in place, and then slide your axle in. Next step, insert the side gear into the differential housing. Make sure the axle doesn't fall out of the fulcrums and they stay in position. Next, the thrust washer. There's a little nub on the side of the thrust washer that fits into the opening.
Okay, wrote that into place.
Next up, circlip washer. Get your circlip pliers. I'm squeezing the clip so it'll fit into the groove and hold the thrust washer and gear in place. Then I rotate the clip around to make sure it's fully seated in the groove.
Okay, make sure that's seated in there real good.
Now I'm lubing up the daisy or the plastic spacer. This should snap into place.
When it comes to putting these gaskets on, some people use a little bit of RTV or gasket sealer on them. And I don't do that because the one time I did do it, I put it on too thick and that affected the spacing of the axle once it was installed. It can be done if you put on a really thin amount, just like a tiny bit all around to seal it. That will help prevent leaks. A lot of people swear by that. Factory method is to put these on dry as is. And the whole point of this exercise is to use the axle reinforcement plates. So I'm gonna put these on dry.
I've already figured out that I need two gaskets on this side, so I won't bore you with all the footage of me test fitting the axle tube, fitting it on, and taking it off. Now I'm sliding the axle tube over the axle. Now I'm putting on the reinforcement plates. Ideally, they should pop right in, but I'm having a little trouble getting them on, mainly because of the way they're machined, or maybe because the studs aren't perfectly perpendicular, so I just have to angle them on and force them down. Once they're on, I put on the washer, lock washers, and thread the nuts down. I tighten down gradually all around in a star pattern before torquing down to 14 foot-pounds. Next, the internal spacer. Make sure the beveled edge points inwards towards the transaxle. And now the wheel bearing goes down on the end of the axle, tapping it down carefully with a punch. The passenger side axle tube is done, and I repeat the same process on the left.
Okay, so there it is, it's done. These reinforcement plates are hopefully going to prevent leaks, and we'll see. Once it's installed, once the car is running, I'm going to post a follow-up video to see if that's actually the case or if this was a big waste of time. Time will tell.
In part two, I'll cover mounting the transaxle on the chassis and finishing off the axle with the outer spacer, O-rings, gasket, and axle cover. So stay tuned for part two because it's gonna be awesome. Wow, these graphics are fancy. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and turn on your notifications. It's a waste of money.